was the first liver transplant that was done in South Australia. So John Chin, who's the head of liver transplant, is going to tell us about that.
Thank you, Rob. So the last 12 months, the liver transplant unit celebrated two significant milestones. One was such in the 30-year anniversary last year, and this year we achieved 500 liver transplant. I'm aware that this is the last PowerPoint presentation, so most of it will be pictorial form. So just going back to the history of setting up a liver transplant unit, we are the fourth unit to start in 1992, following the Queensland, New South Wales, as well as Victoria. So the history of setting out of the liver transplant unit was documented in this particular chapter in the Liver Transplant of Australia booklet. The significant contributor to setting out of the liver transplant unit is Rob Pedbury, Jim Tooley, plus a lot of others whose name will appear shortly. So the unit was set out in 1992 after Rob returned from Birmingham as well as Paris. And there was intense planning activity from 1992. You can see all the names there. The people that participated in planning of this, including Jim Tooley, McKinnon, and a lot of others that was shown here. The unit was set up based on the Birmingham model, which was the largest liver transplant unit in Europe at that stage. I think that SA introduced the concept of national organ sharing. In fact, Rob initiated this soon after the unit started. So in the early days, this was the early transplant team meeting. As you can see, that was the last time Rob wore a tie. So in this photo, you can see Hugh Harley and Mark McKinnon in the photo. This was taken probably in about 1999. So we did our first liver transplant in October of 1992. And this is just an editorial survey, 25 years of liver transplant about 7 years ago. And one of the significant milestones was done in 1997 when we performed our first liver kidney simultaneous transplantation. And the speed transplantation was performed later that year. And for speed transplantation, we usually split the smaller half go to a child and the larger part go into adult. And we did our first multi-organ DCD retriever in 2006. The people shown on the picture is the Jerry O'Callaghan, and Catherine Hannan was involved in this process. In 2006 and 2007, we did our first DCD liver transplant successfully in Australia. The first DCD transplant was actually attempted in 1968 by Rothschild in RPA, but it wasn't successful. So we celebrated our 100th liver transplant several years ago, and this was celebration was in Rob's office. During that time, there was no liquor license required. So we celebrate our 20th anniversary in Jollibee House nearly 10, 11 years ago now. So at this stage, you look at the founder carefully, it only costs $41 to celebrate this event. This is a photo showing that our 300 liver transplant. This was we have done 500 so far. So this was done probably about 8 years ago. The celebration. You will notice that there's large contingent. These are mainly clinicians plus some theater staff. And you'll notice that in the front next to the K is state of the liver. So what are the significant events in terms of liver transplant over the last 10, 20 years? The introduction of direct antiviral agents for treatment of hepatitis C made a significant difference. It was introduced in Australia in March of 2016, the increase in the curable of hepatitis C. At that stage, we had a number of patients that were listed for transplant of hepatitis C. As a result, the treatment, they were delisted. And the number of liver transplant for HCC peaked at about 40% of the cases in 2015. And after that, it dropped significantly. Up until now, we mainly treat the complication of hepatitis C, such as hepatocellular carcinoma. So the challenges that we face in 2023 is just more pushing of the boundaries. Retransplantation. We've done quite a number of retransplantation lately. Some of these retransplantation are not easy procedure. In the last year or so, we've done two retransplantation. For patients, they were transplanted mainly in Sydney, when they were pediatric at the age of between 5 and 6. And they had split liver, the smaller part of the liver transplanted. These are challenging cases because they had portal hypertension, coagulopathy, and loss of adhesions. So it require a good team effort to get them through the procedure. Now we have older recipients with more comorbid disease. So before the arbitrary cutoff was 65 years of age. So nowadays we are transplanting up to 70 in around that age range. We are definitely transplanting patients with more comorbidities, and we are using older and more marginal organs as well. And more DCE donors after the initial first in 2006. DCE donors are donation after secretory arrest. Those are considered marginal because they have high risk of complications such as poor function. And now we have a lot more patients on the waiting list in 1992. There's pressure to increase the utility of donor organs. And how do we increase the donor pool? South Australia, we are privileged to have the highest donor rate in Australia for at least 2 decades. And because of the high donor rate, in my research, if a donor rate falls below 10, then you need to start a living donor program. If your donor rate is 20 above, you don't need, there should be adequate cadaveric donor to satisfy the needs. So how do we expand the use of marginal grafts, one of which is machine perfusion that is coming in. Machine perfusion, in my estimate, will increase the donor pool by 20-30%. And this also allows better timing of liver transplant because you put the liver on the machine, you can have a transplant, say, at 8 o'clock in the morning rather than in the middle of the night, which may be associated with a poorer outcome. And also, it does decrease marginal graft complication rate with machine perfusion, and it has the potential to decrease waiting list mortality because of more availability of organs. So this is our wish list, and Victoria, Queensland, and New Zealand started using machine perfusion with good results. And with the DCE donor, we used to have a cutoff age of 45. These units are accepting any age up to, there's no age limit for using machine perfusion. Yeah. The perfusion machine costs about $200,000. We are aiming to acquire a machine. We have a private donor base. We are reaching about $130,000 at the moment. But obviously, it needs to go up to an appropriate regulatory approval for the state. And it has potential to decrease waiting list, as mentioned earlier. So, 25th anniversary was celebrated in Stanford Plaza, group of surgeons, coordinators. And this is the, in up till now, we've done 507 liver transplants, of which about 73% are alive and well. And the donor age range. It's indicated there, as well as a recipient age range median of about 53. This age is the number of recipients that we are transplanting are getting older. This is the main graph showing our results over the last 31 years with 507 transplants. is result in decade. The bottom blue line was the first decade, this in the 90s, and the green line is there of middle decade, and the red line is there of the last decade. As you can see, there is improvement in survival with decade. The last decade we are able to achieve, a 5-year survival of 88%, and 10-year survival of 78%, which is one of the highest in the world. We celebrate 500 liver transplant this year. This is a large team member involved. I must say that liver transplant not only involves just surgeon and physician, but there are other teams that contribute, like plastic surgeon, vascular surgeon, ICU, etc. And anesthesia has contributed a lot over the years. And this is published in the recent journal called Advertiser. To celebrate our 500 transplant, this lady ICU nurse was planning a funeral, and her liver has done very well. It's just another 30th anniversary last year. And some of the people involved, these are the engineers of the unit, the coordinators that is central to our working of our unit, hepatologists, surgeons. So I just like to acknowledge the contribution of people that contribute a lot in the past. This is by no means the whole list, and the current staff. Quite a number of surgeons are here tonight, today. And just last thing, and I just want to play this video. Take one.
My name's Jennifer. I had my liver transplant in 2002 when I was 18, and here's what I've been doing for the last 20 years.
She had liver transplant 20 years ago.
If it wasn't in Gothic writing, thanks very much, John. I mean, it's the sort of the stories that make it all worthwhile. The statistics still part of the story, but having some of the patient stuff really makes it all worthwhile. So all those hard yards years ago were worthwhile. Kerry, you keep moving straight up there. Thank you. So we're climbing.